Hi guys, happy Sunday. Hope you're having a great time. And it's a lovely sunny day here. I love sunny days. I know I've mentioned it like I don't know how many times, but I love sunny days. There's just something about the sun that is so positive, right? So so I thought I'd do a nice happy reading for you guys today. So the reading that I'm going to do today is, what is your journey to true love, all right? What is going to be your story, your journey, your own personal journey towards true love, all right? So in front of you are three piles, pile one, pile two, and pile three. Pile one is the lapis lazuli. Pile two is the amethyst. And pile three is the green citrine. All right, so please pause your videos and pick the pile that you feel attracted to, and we will start. Okay, let's start then. I'm excited for this reading. Let's see. Okay, so pile one, what is your journey? What is your story towards true love? Lapis lazuli for pile one. Emotions are running high. The swan. The Ten of Swords, Great Adventure, Take a Risk, Venture Forward, Prince of Cups, Two of Cups, and Seven of Coins. All right, please give me a minute. I also have to get the book for my journey of love. Please give me a minute. Okay, so I have got the book and now let us start. I hope it fits, guys. Yeah, I guess. Righto. Okay, let me just figure out these cards. Right, I think this is quite visible. Right, now I think pile one, this has been your love life, I sense. You know, there's been a lot of, and obviously this is a general reading, so please take it as it resonates. It might not resonate for some, but whatever doesn't resonate, please leave it. All right, I do feel with pile one that, you guys are, you know, you've had it a little tough in love, all right? I mean, which of us hasn't? That's a bit of a generalization. But I do feel, you know, with you guys, you're emotional people. You're very sensitive people, emotional people, and probably very heart-centered. And I think you've had, you know... with this Ten of Swords here, I sense that, you know, it's possible that, you know, you've had, you know, an ending in a very significant relationship, okay? Or multiple endings, you know, in relationships as such, romantic relationships. And, you know, that's kind of made you very emotional, I feel. I feel you people are emotional people, sensitive people. It's made you very emotional. And, you know, you do have a tendency to also be emotional when it comes to love. I do feel that. And it's been tough, I sense. For quite some period of time, I am seeing that, you know, you've always wanted a great love, a big love, okay, a true love, you know, great adventure in your life. But somehow, you know, things just kept falling apart is what I'm hearing, okay? You know, you wait, you are invested in the relationship, and then suddenly it falls apart. Okay, I think this has either been a trend for a lot of you in pile one, or it's possible that it has happened with one very significant relationship, which might have been a soulmate relationship. And that's kind of, you know, like made you feel very, I mean, made you go through something major, I sense. Okay, and it might have been a long relationship for some of you, I'm sensing. It might have been a soulmate one. It might have triggered you. It might have brought up a lot of issues. It also brought a lot of learning, I sense. But there is a sense of endings here. Okay, so please take it how it resonates. Now, with the Swan card, I am sensing that, you know, it was like that part of your life was crucial to your journey. All right, that part of your life was crucial to your journey because you were turning into the Swan. All right, so I'm going to read this card because I want to explore what that means. The oracle reaches to you now, indicating that you are held within the grace of a great soul, a teacher of the heart, of the spirit, and there is endless light bestowed upon you for protection. Your path ahead is assured. Soon you will be shifting from hope to a sense of inevitability in your attainment of the spiritual goals closest to your heart. Be with your practice of love through meditation, yoga, kindness, nature, dance, singing, whatever speaks to your heart. And know you are one with the divine, and it's only a matter of time before you realize it. Yeah, so what I am really seeing here is that, you know, it's like you are going to come to a timeout after whatever happens. I mean, you could be in any stage of the journey here towards your true love. It is possible you could be in the breakup stage. It's possible you could be in the waiting stage. It is possible you are in the mending stage after a breakup, okay? And you are now turning into the Swan is what I'm seeing. All right. It's almost like, you know, these tough relationships made you learn how beautiful you really are, they taught you your self-worth. They taught you that, you know, looking outside, looking externally for love, at the cost of your own hurt or pain, does not really make sense. You know, it taught you some sort of lesson about self-love, about your own confidence, okay, about loving yourself and putting yourself first, you know, rather than the other person. And I do feel that that's been a long journey for you guys. You know, it's been a long journey, either in one relationship or multiple. It's been a long journey for you to unfold into the Swan self that you have become, that you will become. All right, I'm really getting very strong energies from the Swan, and I'm literally seeing the Swan. It's almost like, you know, you finally seeing the beauty within you and not needing another person, you know, to show you how beautiful you are. Okay, this is a very big lesson on your journey to true love, I sense, pile one. All right. It's possible you have been looking for that, you know, some sort of appreciation or some sort of support, some sort of motivation, encouragement, you know. But now what you're supposed to learn on this journey is that you are your own motivator. You are your own lover first. Okay. And you are the most beautiful person first. When you start feeling beautiful and appreciated and loved within yourself, you will attract true love. And I sense, you know, the crux of the journey, the midpoint of the journey is you coming into this understanding that you are indeed a swan. And it's going to, you know, it's possibly been a tough ride, you know, to that place it's going to be or is, or, you know, please apply it as it fits. For some people, I also feel you might have, you know, children. Okay, it's possible you might have, you know, a broken marriage or a broken relationship and a child with that, you know, so it's been tough, you know, that's what I'm sensing, it's been tough. But once you step into your power, there is great adventure, you know, that is awaiting you, and I'm loving this card. I'm loving this card, I'm loving this energy, okay, because with, great adventure and with the swan, I mean, I don't know why I sense both of these as similar energies. And you know, because this looks like a swan, although I know it's a dragon, but something about this imagery is telling me of your unfurling, of your unfolding, you know, of limitations being removed from yourself, from within yourself, from without yourself. It's like you are finally going to explore your beautiful self, your swan self, all right? I am sensing that, you know, for some of you, it is possible that you will, after going through this tough time, whatever it is, a tough relationship, a breakup, whatever it is, you know, you will start concentrating on yourself a lot, okay? Stand in your own power. And I also sense you looking physically your best at that time, you know, because swans remind you of beauty. So I sense, whether you're a guy or a girl, whatever it is, I sense that there's great, that you will be in your most physically, mentally, spiritually attractive self at that point of time. All right. And then your adventure towards true love begins. Okay, I am sensing that, you know, you might meet your person on a trip. It might be a cruise, or you know, as you can see, it's some sort of boating. You know, maybe you're in some sort of boating thing, or I don't know what to call it, but you know, I'm sensing the sea here, you know, so it's possible you're doing some sort of water sports or something like that, or, you know, or even a cruise, a river cruise or a boating adventure or something like that. Or it is even possible that you meet this person while you're traveling. Okay, I am seeing that, you know, this is going to be like divinely orchestrated, this travel, this move, or this place that you go to where you're going to meet the person. It's going to be divinely orchestrated, I sense, you know, because I see the sails here, and that to me is the spirit moving you in a certain direction. You know, there's a green flag there, and, you know, you're moving in this direction. It's also possible that your person, you know, would be the one who's moving in your direction, okay, as guided by the spirit. So it's possible there is some sense of different locations over here. So it might be on a trip, on a travel, on you know, vacation even. All right, I'm sensing that you guys might meet there. Okay, now, with the Swan card and the Prince of Cups, I am seeing that, you know, your person might be quite nice looking. All right, obviously, you know, looks, beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. So, you know, they would be attractive to you at least, right? I am, however, sensing, you know, very conventionally good looks, actually. I am sensing that, you know, someone who's very pleasant and attractive to look at. Okay, I also feel that, you know, your person would be the one to approach you first. I'm seeing the sea and the river and all of that again here. Okay, so it's almost like, you know, and then there's this emotions running high. So I feel, okay, you know, that this relationship, this true love that you actually encounter, it's going to be a very emotional relationship, All right, it's going to be full of emotions, a lot of genuine, deep emotions. A sea of love is what I'm hearing, okay? Now, I feel this person's going to approach you with the Prince of Cups. You know, it could be a girl or a guy. You know, maybe a water sign, I feel, Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer, in their charts. And I feel this person is going to approach you. I also feel this person is going to be pretty intuitive because I see the moon here, and to me that kind of, you know, tells me that this person's intuitive, and that's possibly why they are the ones who would spot you and come to you. And then you have your Two of Cups. And I love this deck and I love this card, okay? Because to me, this is looking like a relationship which will stand the test of time. Okay, this is your great adventure. This is your journey. This is your conclusion to the journey of true love. All right, your soulmate, your twin flame, your divine counterpart. All right, someone who will stay with you through thick and thin. If you notice, there is a desert here. There seems to have been some flooding, and there is a lightning over here. So it's almost like, you know, this whole land has been destroyed, but you two cannot stop looking at each other and being there for each other. So this is a relationship that will stand the test of time, no matter what calamities that come in your life, no matter what obstacles that you face in your life. This person is going to be staying by your side, is going to be holding you, is going to be, you know, on the same page, same level of love, you know, no matter what, is what I'm hearing. All right, this, your journey to true love, pile one, is going to be this great adventure. All right, it's going to be a great adventure with this person. It's going to be a relationship which is, you know, something you've always waited for, something you've always hoped for, something that will appreciate the beauty in you, the true beauty, the inner beauty, the outer beauty. Okay, it's going to be, you know, like the biggest adventure I'm hearing of your lifetime. So it's possible, you know, pile one, that you guys might have limited yourself, you know, saying that I don't know if you know, I even deserve a love like that. I don't know, you know, because I've had it so tough. But no, you do deserve that kind of love because it will come. Obviously, I cannot comment on the timing here, but this is the central card. Two of Cups is the central card. And when I pair this up with the Seven of Pentacles, this is something worth waiting for. So if any of you have, you know, kind of are in that feeling of giving up, of never wanting anything, of being emotional, maybe crying about it because of whatever heartbreak you faced in the past, cry not, okay? Because your savior will come, all right? Your comforter is what I'm hearing, all right? I sense from this card as well that it's possible you might relocate with this person. It's possible you might take a lot of trips with this person. This is a relationship that is going to lead you to, you know, a lot of joyful moments I'm seeing. It's like, you know, the biggest adventure of your life, you know, going, it's possible it would indicate going on vacations with this person, traveling the world, traveling the globe, you know, kind of trying new things, you know, I'm seeing. And being your true authentic self, you know, being a swan, being someone who is beautiful, and this person is going to make you feel like that. I sense this is a very big indicator, the great adventure that I'm seeing here. This is a very big indicator, okay? And it also says, this card says, take a risk, venture forward. So I sense, pile one, that because of whatever you have faced in the past, you might be a little reticent. You might be, you know, in this energy of not wanting to really try anything new, or just being too emotional, you know, just thinking with your emotions, over emotional, I sense. All right. But the spirit is asking you to take a risk, venture forward. All right. Never give up hope is what I'm hearing. All right. Because people who do not give up hope are always the ones who will, you know, get what it is that they want. I mean, don't let obstacles, don't let obstacles kill your hope, okay? Kill your spark. Because I do sense heavy energies, you know, with whatever you are going through or have gone through. You know, it's almost a sense of, you know, like, I don't know if I'll ever get that, you know. I've invested so much, but I never got anything. But you have to take the risk. Never stop taking risks, you know, is what I'm hearing very insistently by the spirit in this pile, all right? Because something so beautiful is going to be revealed to you. So you need to go out there when you're ready. I'm not saying, you know, the moment you have, you know, a breakup or, you know, you feel like crying and then you go out partying. No, I mean, when you're healed, give yourself that time, give yourself that, the healing energy so that you turn into the swan and then move ahead on this journey. Okay, because you have, you know, someone who is going to make it feel worthwhile that you went through all of this, pile one. Someone who, you know, I don't know why, but I keep seeing this card and I see the way they're holding each other and looking at each other and holding each other's faces. And I get a very strong sense from this card that you guys have faced a lot of, I mean, you guys have a lot of history behind you. It's possible this is a person you know. Or it's possible that you have shared many lifetimes with this person. I'm actually seeing lifetimes here, you know. You guys have been in lifetimes where you have stuck through thick and thin, through tragedies, through adventures, through the highs and lows. You guys always stick together. All right. You have this on your journey, pile one, and I feel it's worth taking the risk and venturing forward. Despite whatever, high emotions are running right now, despite you feeling emotional, despite you feeling not good enough or whatever it is, you know, any heavy energy, this is worth going for, guys. And you really don't have to do too much. I sense, I feel this person will approach you, this person will recognize you. This person will recognize your swan self. They will see the inner you because you have shared so much. You have history together. So be patient. Be patient, okay? If you have not met this person yet, be patient and concentrate on self-love. On self-development, all right, on healing yourself, on ending any limiting patterns, any limiting beliefs that you're holding regarding love, all right, walk out from things that are not serving your highest purpose, because your coming into your own is going to set off this big energy of attracting your person towards you. And this is the conclusion of your journey of love, the Two of Cups. This is going to be a relationship that is going to stand the test of time, I sense. It is going to be at least a very large part of your life for a long period of time. It's going to be emotional. It's going to be tender. It's going to be nourishing. It's going to be intuitive. It's going to be healing. This is beautiful, pile one. Okay, it's going to make you, it's going to show you how it feels like to be happy in love, you know, because I sense, pile one, you've probably had it tough and you've had this thing of, you know, maybe you have this thought that, you know, love really is not about happiness, you know, it's so much hard work. But this is not going to be hard work. This is going to be
you know, something that introduces you back to your emotions, back to your happiness, to your joy, to your sense of adventure. I'm seeing you so joyful when you meet this person. Okay, so so this is what I am getting. I was spiraling a bit at that time. Please excuse me, but I think we probably needed to hear that. But this is something that is coming to nourish you, to reintroduce you back to joy, is what I'm seeing. Pile one. All right, so keep going. Whichever stage of the journey you are in, keep going. Don't give up, all right? Because this is coming. Okay, now let's go to pile two. I did want to, you know, read the poem for this card, for the swan. It says, to love from afar, all we share are dreams of what will unfold. I sense with this poem, pile one, it's possible that you guys are, you know, dreaming about this person or have dreamt about this person, and there's some sort of a psychic or intuitive connect between you and the person. So if you already know the person, you've been dreaming about them, you're receiving some communication from them. If you don't know this person, then there's a sense of someone communicating energetically, psychically. Okay, you probably have an intuition of how this person even looks like, or you know, how it's going to be. So yeah, this is what I'm seeing for pile one. All right. So let's go to pile two. So pile two with the amethyst. What is your journey to true love? Believe in the impossible. Blue moon. The bride offers herself. Wise leader, you are a beacon for others. Sacrifice. This is the hanged man. Eight of Wands, Awakening. This is the Sun card in this deck. And Love, right? Okay. All right, so let me, just give me a minute, guys. I hope this fits. Yes. So pile one, sorry, pile two. Okay. Very interesting. All right. Now, the thing with pile two here, I'm seeing right off the bat, the very first thing I'm seeing in your journey to true love, right? I'm sensing that there's going to be some sacrifice involved before you reach the connection with your true love. All right, now with this sacrifice, it could be, I feel, it could be walking out of a connection or a marriage or whatever, you know, walking out on a previous relationship. I'm seeing that very clearly here. It's possible that either the person you were involved with walks out on you and you don't want them to go, or you know, you walking out on someone and they don't want you to go. I am sensing a soulmate relationship here. It would be tough for you to give up on this relationship. All right, it's almost like, you know, when they say sacrifice, and this deck is very different. You know, it's the Hanged Man, but it's this deck is different. So it's almost like, you know, you would be connected to someone, and possibly, you know, that person might not be for your highest good. You might be stuck in a relationship or in a marriage or something, or in a situation even, you know, which requires you to sort of, you know, gain, you know, a higher perspective and walk away from. I am sensing that very first thing for pile two here. There is some sort of an entanglement, some sort of a situation that you will need to come to a decision about and give up on. And I do sense it's going to be tough. This decision is going to be tough because, you know, I sense that, you know, both of you people, if it's a person, then, you know, both of you are quite, you know, how do I say it? You're quite involved with each other. All right. It's possible it's been an off and on. It's possible, you know, you tried to walk away and they came back and they called you back and you went back, or vice versa. They tried to walk away, you call them, and, you know, they came back. So it never broke, really. You know, that is what I'm sensing with this card here. So it was stagnant, however, you know, I am, because this is the Hanged Man card, I would say it was something stagnant. It was something up in the air. It was something going on for some time, and it could even be a situation, you know, which requires you to have a higher perspective, okay? And sort of, you know, like, what I'm seeing here, the energies I'm getting here is, it's going to be tough for you guys, you know, to kind of decide about the situation. All right, so there is a feeling of a touch and go here. Okay, so for some of you, if you don't walk out of this, I don't think you are going to meet this person, the love of your life. Okay, because this one is probably a primary soulmate. All right, this one is not a bad person. This is not a bad relationship. It's a little stagnant. Yes, it's a little slow. It's not for your highest good. So it's fine, you know, I mean, whatever you choose, you know, it depends. If you stay with this person, it's fine, you know, because I do sense there's a strong bond here, all right? But in case you decide to sacrifice this relationship because you feel that it is not for your highest good, you know, you decide to let go, or they decide to let go, or something like that, and this could be a situation as well, you know, take it how it resonates. You doing that and would, okay, so what I'm getting here is, first, that there is some sort of a sacrifice involved in this connection. The second is, believe in the impossible. All right, now this is a card that is really attracting me here. All right, because I sense, you know, this is about wish fulfillment. This is about you chasing a dream which you always had, maybe, you know, which seemed impossible. And this card is telling me that, you know, after walking away from something that was limiting, you would probably start, you know, manifesting this dream. All right, you would start believing in the impossible. You would start going by your intuition with the moon card there, with the moon there. Okay, I sense that this is going to be a lot about your creative energies, your manifestation. All right, so, you know, despite what you've gone through, you would still have the positivity to believe in this impossible dream and try to manifest it. This is what I'm seeing. This is also a message from the spirit to believe in the impossible, to believe in a love that is impossible. All right, love doesn't always have to be stagnant. In fact, it's not supposed to be stagnant. It's supposed to bring you your highest happiness, right? once you take this step, and I really keep coming back to that because I feel this step is very important, you know, if you were to meet this person, all right? Once you do that, right, you are going to be doing something impossible, I sense. You know, this leap of faith that you would take, you know, in sacrificing this stagnancy here, this connection maybe, you know, is going to set forward some sort of, you know, force or energy, you know, very quickly, very rapidly in your life. All right. I'm sensing this as your manifestation, your wishes, your dreams coming true, you know, very fast. All right. Because you believed in the impossible and now the impossible is going to be showered upon you. All right. It's, and I sense with the eight of wands here, I sense this is going to happen fast for you guys. Okay. In pile two, it's going to be fairly fast. I obviously don't want to go into timings here, but I do feel that this is going to happen soon. All right. Now, I also feel that, you know, for some of you, I feel you guys are leaders or, you know, people who are healers, leaders, light workers, you know, someone who is in some capacity in the public eye. All right. There is a sense about you guys that you have vast amounts of maturity and maybe even spiritual development. Okay. There is just this solid, rock solid core to you, okay, that makes you take leaps of faith and believe in the impossible, which sets things moving, I sense. All right. This could also be the person that you're going to meet on this journey. All right. I sense that the way you're going to meet this person is through your work. All right. So whatever field you're involved in, I sense, whatever field you're involved in, it could be in any area of your life, your career, your hobby, whatever. I sense more of career here, okay? I feel that you would meet this person via your field, okay? Maybe it could be at a party or it could be at a gathering or it could even be, you know, through some communication from this person regarding the area you work in. All right. I do sense this as rapid. All right. So, yeah. So I feel you are going to meet this person via your work or something to do with your work. All right. Now, I also feel that it could be possible that your person, the love of your life, is also a leader. All right. Or it could be vice versa. You could be the leader. They could be the leader. It could be both of you being leaders. Please take it as it resonates. But I do sense that, you know, with the Sun card here and the wise leader here, this is a person possibly who's going to be prominent, you know, who's going to be a leader in the public eye, maybe famous. All right. Maybe someone who is looked up to by people. All right. So I'm sensing, you know, an energy of leadership here. Someone who probably is a fire sign. I don't know why I'm getting fire sign. Maybe because of the Sun card here. I'm getting fire sign and the wands here. I do feel that maybe your person is a fire sign. Could be Aries, Leo, Sag, or prominent placements of these zodiacs in their charts. All right. I do feel very strongly, I'm feeling this person might be some sort of a leader in their field, or you might be a leader in your field. And, you know, there is this public eye on you, all right, or them. And you might first connect via messages, all right, or phone calls or messages or something like that. I'm seeing a lot of back and forth communication from here, and maybe based on the field that you're working in, all right. Now, I also feel with this card and its imagery, it is something to do with an awakening. All right. You are going to awaken to this connection, and you're going to awaken to this connection very rapidly, I sense, with the Eight of Wands and the awakening, which is actually the Sun, frankly. Okay. I sense that, you know, it's like you probably might have already known about this person. They might have come in your dreams or something like that. Or you might have come in their dreams, all right? There is a sense of dreaming about each other or being telepathically in connect with this person before you meet this person, is what I'm feeling. All right, so it's almost like, you know, it might have taken you by surprise that, you know, it's possible that, you know, you might have known this person is coming, you know, and that kind of took you by surprise, you know, it was awakening of sorts, or it could be vice versa. Your person was taken by surprise because somewhere they already were connecting with you, they already had an awakening. I'm sensing something spiritual here. Maybe it's a spiritual connection, sacred connection, whatever it is, okay? But there is a feeling here of knowing about this person. Knowing, but not knowing, all right? So you don't know what that person is all about, who they are, how they look like. But you have probably had some epiphanies, some downloads, some dreams, you know, telling you that, you know, there is someone like this, you know, who's coming up. Okay, that is what I'm getting. Now, with the bride offers herself card, I am going to read this card out, but I feel that it is about, it's possible you might be people, because I did say that you might be leaders in your field or something like that. It's possible you might have to compromise on something. Okay, it's possible you might have to compromise on your ego or something like that. I'm seeing, you know, the bride offers herself seems to be, in terms of the sentence itself, that maybe you might have to compromise and come forward to this person. All right, or it could be vice versa. All right. Now, I do feel it might be the feminine who might do that. All right. It might be the feminine who might need to sort of, you know, adjust a bit and accept this connection. I am going to read this card. So let's see. Yeah, it says the oracle offers you a message. Accept what is being offered now. Whether through challenge or an easing of the way forward, there is a gift of grace from the divine feminine reaching for you now. Allow her in and be blessed. This oracle also heralds a time of importance in relationship. You have been revealing yourself and not being afraid of who and what you are, sharing yourself in willingness to connect. Your vulnerability and beauty is acknowledged and will attract the response you need at the perfect time and in the perfect way. Every bride shall have her bridegroom. Okay, and the poem says, how careful we must be close, how fragile we must feel, how sad not to be when someone is real. To say approach with caution when we already know that inside there's a likeness and experience goes slow. Yeah. So I am seeing that, you know, it's possible you might have to adjust to this person. There is something about compromising, about showing your vulnerability. Vulnerability is what I'm seeing here, you know. So it's possible because this person is someone who is, you know, a leader, okay, or someone who has that kind of personality. I sense your person, whoever it is, a girl or a guy, you know, take it as it resonates, has this kind of a very radiant personality, I sense, all right? I feel that this person might be someone famous or might be looking very good. Is this something about this person that just attracts people's attention? Okay, they are something like a crowd puller. Either they speak very well or they look really good or they just have that aura of magnetism. All right. And I do feel that, you know, you might have to come down. You might have to accept that. All right. You might have to accept that possibly, you know, that is how they are. All right, that might be, I'm sensing, I don't know why, I'm sensing that might be a little bit of a compromise for you, because I feel you yourself are a person who is quite strong and also a leader, you know, in your own way. So there are some adjustments that I'm seeing here. I am also seeing with this poem when it says to say approach with caution when we already know that inside there's a likeness and experiences go slow. So this is going to be something that, you know, you guys might explore slowly. All right, because there is a sense, there is this, with this awakening card, there is a sense of already knowing this person. All right, so your souls know each other, right? But the externals don't match very well, I sense. All right, and so this connection might unfold slowly and steadily. Okay, it says how careful we must be close, how fragile we must feel, how sad not to be when someone is real. So yeah, I am sensing here, you know, that there is a sense of, you know, like fragility or whatever, however you pronounce it. You know, maybe both of you are going to be really scared of making the wrong moves in this connection, because you know, it's such a special relationship. It's, you know, it's something that you've believed in. It's something that has manifested. And so now, you know, you're all, both of you, I sense both of you, okay? Both of you are all sort of, you know, like bound up in taking it easy, you know, taking it step by step and not wanting to make any wrong moves that would make the person go away, right? So it's, that is the sense I'm getting for this journey here. And obviously, you know, after that, once you are, you know, done with these kind of adjustments, there's love. There is true love and the sun. And believe in the impossible. I mean, what else can I say? You know, this is beautiful because I do feel that, you know, with these three cards here, believe in the impossible, believe in love pile two. Believe in true love, because you have the lover's card here, and this is a beautiful card. I mean, it's simply beautiful. It's like you guys are intertwined with each other, you know, it's joy. And then with the sun here, it's like, you know, it's going to be a future filled with joy. Filled with joy, filled with love, filled with miracles, communication. Also adjustments, I sense, okay? Because both of you are like this power couple. You are both, you know, like really forces to contend with. And then I also see this sort of leading to some sort of a work, you know? Like both of you are leaders, and maybe this is something like your life path or, you know, soul path, life mission or something like that, you know? So this is going to be you guys as an example of true love, you know, leading the way to others. Maybe not just with your relationship, but maybe with the work you do. Because I do sense that you guys might join forces when it comes to work. All right. Or you might join this person in their work, or they might join you in their in your work, something like that. All right. I do feel that, you know, this relationship will be a beacon of light for others. The way it unfolds is almost like an example for everybody, you know, to actually embody. All right, so yeah, this is your journey to true love. It's a major arcana card, and I do feel pile two that you know, I mean, it's almost like, you know, you fall into each other's arms after all of these whatever adjustments you go through. It's like you fall into each other's arms and you admit that, you know, okay, I can't do without you. Let's forget the ego now, you know. So that's what I'm seeing. All right, so this is going to happen fairly soon. I sense you guys would have an intuition about this person. I do feel you might need to adjust some things, but this is something that is going to be a beacon of light for others, because it was something, you know, that probably pile two, you never thought would happen, but it happened. So this is your journey, pile two, and it's simply beautiful. It's very powerful energies, because these are all, most of them are major arcanas. You've got the lovers, you've got the sun, you've got the hangman. I mean, wow, that was intense. All right. Now let's go to pile three. Green citrine. a new romantic cycle begins, new moon in Libra. Within nothing, there is everything. Breaking trail, a breakthrough is at hand. King of Arrows. Two of Wands. Justice. And Ten of Pentacles. All right. So please give me a minute. I am thinking about this pile because it's very interesting. You know, okay, so pile three, the first thing that I'm getting in this is that, you know, your journey to true love is, it's like you're creating something on a canvas. So I sense it's manifestation somehow. All right, that's the first card that I am looking at and I am getting very attracted to, okay? With the Two of Wands and the Justice card, it's almost like having a future vision and creating or painting it. This is what I'm getting, the first thing first, all right? I do sense, you know, with this card of within nothing, there is everything. This is your creative potential. And pile three, I sense that you are manifesting the love of your life. You, this is, I sense, you know, this journey towards your true love was something that you manifested, you created. You had the creative material. This looks like a womb, you know, and this, you know, it's just waiting for, you know, the fetus actually. Yeah. So this is you creating, your journey, your true love. I'm getting a very strong sense of creation here, of planning and creating with the Two of Wands, the within nothing, there is something, and Justice. I am seeing that you guys probably have created something, all right? You are going to create your journey, pile number three. I sense you're very powerful people in terms of your creative manifestations. And I feel that, you know, you are the one who's going to be making something out of nothing, you know? Within nothing, there is everything, right? So I am sensing that you, this is something that's going to happen in your journey. Whatever you've gone through in the past, I do sense that, I don't sense too many problems here in the past for you guys, as a matter of fact. I feel it's been very, everything's been very justified in your life. It's possible it might have not moved too much, it might have been a little stagnant, but I feel that, you know, with you guys, pile three, please take it as it resonates, but I don't think you've had too many, you know, tower moments in your life or really bad things in love. I don't sense that you've had it very bad. With this card, within nothing, there is everything. I'm also sensing that it's possible you guys went through a breakup. You know, because this is like, this, I don't know why this card is really attracting me. To me, it seems as though there was something and then it became nothing, right? So it's possible for some of you, you know, that you had everything with the Ten of Coins with somebody, all right? Maybe with this King of Arrows. You had something and then, you know, it was either taken away or it just kind of, you know, ran its course, right? You had nothing to learn. You had nothing left to learn. So you were just like, you know, plodding along in your life, you know, enjoying yourself. I sense with this card, you know, it's almost like, you know, she's creating something and, you know, she's enjoying her work, right? It's almost like she's turned away from whatever. There is nothing here. There's nothing left. Okay, so she or he is, you know, just concentrating on their career, maybe on their passion, on their hobby, something like that. Okay, now I feel that for you guys in your journey, this is probably what would have happened. You probably would have thought that, okay, whatever I have is fine for me. All right, whatever I have is fine for me. And I'm going to continue doing that and I'm going to be happy doing that. All right, I think that's what was there for some of you. Take it how it resonates. But I sense that in your journey somewhere, pile three, you balanced out the scales of karma, okay? There has come a point where the scales of karma are balanced with this justice card. And suddenly your life has a breakthrough. All right, I am sensing this as something sudden. All right, it's almost like, no, actually I'm not sensing it as anything sudden. I feel you've been doing this. I did talk about you know, manifestation in the beginning, and I do feel that this has been you manifesting. It's been a slow and steady digging. This person is digging a sort of tunnel, and this person's planning. All right, so it's almost like, you know, you were working on something. You were working, either you were working on manifesting this person or you were doing some work, okay? But this true love connection, this Ten of Pentacles, this new romantic cycle that is coming up, that in your journey for you, pile three, is going to be some sort of a breakthrough. Either you've been manifesting it or it's just something that will happen. All right. You've broken trail. You've had a breakthrough. All right. And, you know, now now that this breakthrough has happened, I sense a new romantic cycle begins. All right. Now, if I look at this energy here, the new romantic cycle begins, breaking trail, and you as justice, they as two of wands. I feel it's almost like both of you have been working towards each other here. All right. It's almost like collective energies, because this is Libra, new moon in Libra. It's a balance, right? It's also justice, which is again Libra. Okay. So I'm sensing a lot of Libra energies here. It's possible your person might be an air sign or you might be an air sign, you know, maybe Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini. But I'm getting a lot of Libra energy. So it's almost like both of you, you know, both of you are working towards, you know, each other. All right. You with your creative expression, I'm seeing you do something more tangibly, and your person is more about thoughts and plans and ideas. All right. And then suddenly the trail breaks, you know, you have a breakthrough in this connection and this new romantic cycle begins. All right, so I'm sensing here that this is like a equally demanded relationship by both the parties in this journey of your love. All right, and I also feel that your person might be this King of Arrows or Queen of Arrows, whatever gender you are. So this person might be an air sign, or they might have prominent air placements in their chart. All right, and I sense with this card that your person might appear a bit haughty, a bit arrogant, or a bit too much in their head, you know, at first when you meet them. All right, so it's almost like, you know, you were expecting a certain kind of person and you get this kind of person. All right, and there's a lot of air energy here, so you know, it's possible even with this also, you know. So this is the King of Swords. So this person might be closed up at first. Okay, I sense a little dominating. I'm seeing this as dominating, closed up, but they still have flaws with them here. So to me, it seems like this person might ask you out or might declare their feelings or something like that, but you might not like it because this person's closed up. Okay, so it's possible they might not show their true authentic self to you, and you might find that a little, you know, not very impressive, I sense. All right, because I'm seeing you just get back to your work, you know, after this person has told you, after they have given you this offer, you know, there's a hesitation from their side. There seems to be a sort of energy of, you know, not being very impressed or not being very, what do you call it, shaken by this person's offer. You know, it's almost like, you know, they tell you they admire you and then you just brush it off and then continue doing your work. You know, maybe because this person might not be your type of person. I'm sensing that very strongly because, you know, I don't know why I'm sensing that very strongly here. Because I think this lady seems so grounded here that I'm seeing literally like you being in this energy, or it could be vice versa also. Please take it how it resonates. But you being in this grounded energy, very much into your work, very much supported by your spirit guides and, you know, really enjoying yourself. Whereas this person, okay, seems to be approaching you with some sort of caution. You know, they don't understand why you're so calm, what makes you so self-assured. Although they are the King of Arrows, although they are the King of Swords, but I think this person has some problem expressing their authentic true self or expressing emotion. And that doesn't interest you. So I'm seeing this as something interesting here, okay? That might happen on your journey, all right? But this is definitely with this card of a new romantic cycle begins. I sense that this is something, this is someone who's going to be new. All right, someone brand new. This is not, I sense, anybody from your past. All right, this is someone absolutely brand new. It's also somebody who, now when I see justice and the new romantic cycle begins, it's like the universe is bringing justice to you. The universe is bringing you your due because the scales of karma are balanced now. Because possibly you are in balance now, or they are in balance now. Your masculines and your feminine energies within you are also balanced. And I sense because of that, you know, both of you come together and this new romantic cycle begins. And of course, last but not the least, this is the person that you are going to have a beautiful and long future with. All right, I am seeing family. I'm seeing family, I'm seeing house. Ten of Pentacles is generally about house, family, settling down. In this card, I'm literally seeing, like, you know, the gates to a palace open up. So it's possible that you guys, you know, buy some sort of a house or relocate somewhere. You know, this all seems very grand and mighty. So I don't know, you know, please take it as it resonates. It's possible it could be a new move to a new house, to a new location. You know, I'm seeing a lot of abundance. I'm actually seeing both of you quite on the same page, as a matter of fact. You know, both of you are equally distinguished. Both of you are equally distinguished. Both of you are equally well known, or maybe just, you know, stable in your life. You know, both of you are like that.
So I sense this is going to be a meeting of two equals. With the Libra energy here also, I'm sensing this as a meeting of equals. I am not sensing any codependency here. All right, I do sense that maybe you might not be able to figure out this person initially because they are a little cautious or something like that, or they're very brain-centered and that doesn't really interest you. All right, but or vice versa, it could be vice versa, but something about this connection I feel is going to just open up the doors to a very beautiful future. All right, this is a new love, this is a breakthrough love. All right, this is probably something that both of you have manifested in your life, and with the Two of Wands and the Ten of Pentacles, this is going to be something that is going to last for a long time to come, I sense. All right, it is something you have wanted. Maybe both of you have wanted it, all right? And this is something that is going to happen because, you know, you've made some sort of a breakthrough. I don't know what that breakthrough is. Apply it as it fits, but I sense, you know, that there is some breakthrough moment in this journey of yours, pile three, that's going to happen, all right, which is going to set off this new romantic cycle, which will bring you this person, all right. I sense with this, with your person, like I said, they could be air signs. I feel this person's going to be very sharp looking. I'm seeing aquiline features. Like generally air signs have that, you know, I'm seeing them, maybe they could be Libra for a lot of you, I sense, you know, or having a Libra moon, sun or ascendant, all right? This person is going to be a very good looking person, whether it's a man or a woman, whoever it is. Very good looking, someone who's going to be maybe a bit hesitant with words, I sense, all right? I do feel that. Not very expressive, all right? And someone who probably can't figure you out initially, all right? I don't know why I keep getting that. I have no clue why. It's like you are cool, but they can't figure you out and they really want to figure you out, okay? They think about you, they plan about it, they want to make a breakthrough with you, all right? And they will make a breakthrough with you because you will come together in this Ten of Pentacles energy, all right? So it's possible that you might teach this person how to express themselves better, to ground themselves. And maybe that person might teach you, to have more breakthroughs, to think better, to sort of excel in your life. All right. Now, this is going to be a marriage, I sense, you know, for a lot of you, a commitment or a marriage, something very solid, something very grounded with this person. All right. And it's possible that, you know, it would need a breakthrough moment before your energies equalize with each other. There could be a time of separation even initially, you know, after your meeting. It's possible that, you know, things brew, you know. That's the energy I'm getting. You know, it's possible that you might need to let this connection unfold, you know, its energies before you two come into this balance, right? I'm going to read this card. Within nothing, there is everything. Right, so it says, the oracle brings a message to you. Something that you want is on its way to you. It may seem to be coming out of nowhere. No sign on the horizon to give you hope, yet it is coming to you anyway. It is spiritual law that you cannot be denied the manifestation of your heart's desire. Trust and remain open to the tide of universal love rushing towards you, swelling within you now. Which brings me back to what I was saying, that I sense there's some major creative energy here. Okay, it's almost like, you know, you've manifested this person. And, you know, because you manifested, the universe is now getting that thing to you. It is coming to you. It's like a tide of universal love rushing towards you, swelling within you now. You're giving birth to this love is what I'm sensing. Because this looks like a womb to me.
And the poem says, "The wind moves gently through trees, quiet water flows. Life's song calls softly." So yeah, you're creating your own symphony, pile three. Okay, you're giving birth to your journey, your path towards this person. You know, it's almost like, to me, I'm getting a very strong energy of manifestation here. And I don't know why, but when I look at this card, I'm getting a lot of things here, and there are some very strange things also that I'm getting. Okay, I'm even seeing 5D connections, 10D connections. You guys are connected on different realms, I sense. This is, to me, this seems like a divine counterpart or whatever, you know, because there's something about both your energies being equal, all right? And you are opening gates to something new, I sense. It's possible that it might be a mission or a life purpose or something like that, because this is like another land altogether. So either you guys are going to be moving to a place like this, maybe after you get together, you guys want some peace and quiet, and you are going to be moving towards a place where there's not too much of chaos, there's not too many people, there's not crowds, there's not automobiles, and you know, I'm seeing a country dwelling kind of a feeling, you know. It's possible you might move to the country, okay, with this person, okay, or it's possible, even if you're looking at it from a mission point of view, from a life purpose point of view, then it's possible you guys are going to be ushering in, you know, some sort of a new way of thinking, new way of believing, behaving. You know, this is looking like a life purpose card to me somehow, but I am not able to tap in too much into this, because within nothing there's everything. So things are kind of like, you know, brewing. The things will be brewing in this connection. There's a lot of manifestation energy in this pile three. So you need to know this, right? You guys are manifestors. You are going to manifest. You are going to create your destiny of love, your journey of love, and beyond, even after you get together with this person. So tap into that power, you know, because you are good at, you know, creating stuff. You are. All right. So this is what I'm getting for you, pile three. I hope it resonates, and I hope you have a wonderful Sunday. And let me know, you know, which stage of the journey you are in, okay? Have a wonderful week ahead and a happy Sunday. Bye.